captain's home.
Captain Kenway, shall we use your ship for this next scheme or mine?
Let's first hear the details before deciding.
Oh, it's a small gambit. This fount of information has just told me that a nearby galleon contains the treasure I seek. For his sake, I hope he's right.
You've thought this plan through?
Indeed. Using this man will acquire a Portuguese flag, which will get us as close to our target as possible. It's a very simple idea, if you follow my orders to the letter.
The jackdaw, then.
Excellent.
We're underway, Roberts.
So what's your plan?
The flagship of this fleet is transporting a valuable treasure in a large chest. Crystal phials filled with blood. You may remember.
We're chasing drams of blood. Is that all?
I asked you to follow my instructions to the letter, Captain. But I did not give you leave to question why. I want those blood vials intact. And if that does not happen, we part as enemies. Do you understand?
I'll try to, huh?
See that ship here? We'll need its flag for this ruse to work.
If I can steal that flag without disturbing so much as a flea, I'll do it.
By all means, try. Come here, Safalak.
Oh, somos hoje, cavaleiro! E que Deus abençoe ao rei Rojão! Que Deus o guarde e proteja, senhor!
Neste momento, em busca de uma arma que sirva de tal propósito.
É muito bom. Não.
quantos duvidos terá?
Compõem a maior parte da nossa frota, senhor. Dos nossos 42 navios, diria que mais de 2/3 são embarcações mercantis.
Ah, um número com... Não medidos tenham como
sair
grande.
Sim, senhor, exatamente. Daí as nossas precauções. Com tantos piratas nestas águas, esta frota necessita de bastante proteção. Não é uma tarefa leve guardar quase 3 dúzias de navios. Peço perdão, senhor, mas não estou a reconhecer o seu navio. Nem sequer transporta a bandeira do rei.
Ah, sim, pois. Falando de virar, é preto para retirar a bandeira. Prazer falar consigo, jovem. Entregue os meus cumprimentos ao seu capitão.
Certo, senhor. Ele, de momento, está a dormir. Vai lamentar não ter tido a oportunidade para falar consigo.
É uma pena. Já posso ver o meu abençoe.
Got the flag?
Aye, and we're flying it now.
This should do nicely.
Let's get moving.
I'll keep my distance, slow and steady.
Aye, the flag we stole won't protect us from eyes that pry too long.
Por favor, senhor, implore-lhe que considere aquilo que está prestes a fazer.
Now it was even.
What's he whinging about?
He's not whinging. He's ecstatic.
Something from that ship.
Could that be our prize? Perhaps you should go ashore, Captain Kimble. Find that chest, and if it contains the prize I seek.
chest they hauled ashore was full of empty vials. Where's our Portuguese captain?
He had outlived his usefulness.
Where is he?
Sleeping soundly at the bottom of the sea.
How many men must we kill for a simple prize?
As many as drift into our path. Why don't you take the ship itself and save us a bit of time?
Aye, that's the way I'd play it.
I can bring the jackdaw closer, but those lookouts would be a problem.
Well spotted. I'll clear them off first.
Está a fazer o tour nesta noite? Ou foste ontem? Perdeu. Estou a perder a conta aos dias.
Passa aqui!
We've been spotted. Took them long enough.
To quarters all, man the cannons! Every last hand!
On your command, Captain! Let's hear the roar of this beast!
Get the mains free! Loose all! Move down to the wind!
Here's my prize. Ah, the Templars have been busy, I see. Lawrence Prince's blood. Useless now. Woods Rogers, Ben Hornigold, even Torres himself. Small quantities kept for a special purpose.
You must take me to the observatory, Roberts. I need to know what it is.
To what end, eh? Will you sell it from under my nose? Or work with me and use it to bolster our gain?
Whatever improves my lot in life.
How ridiculous. A merry life and a short one, that's my motto. It's all the optimism I can muster. All right, Captain Kenway. You've earned a look.
Thank you. What have you been eating today, then? Rum bit of business, that.
Yelvin!
Excellent. Merci, mon ami.
Here's a health to the...
Care to lose all the unwanted attention?
Alguien ha perdido. Se habrá dado. Ha perdido.
De primera, excelente.
Want to be left in peace, my friend?
Un poco imprudente.
Right. You're officially off the hook.
Can you feel it, Addy? We're moments away from the grandest prize of all.
I feel nothing but a hot wind in my ears, Captain.
Come on, man. When we take this treasure, we'll be set for life, all of us. 10 times over.
As you wish.
Ahoy, Roberts. We'll cast anchor and meet ashore.
You were followed, Captain Kenway. How long for, I wonder?
It's Hornigold!
Burn and flay that turncoat.
Deal with your old friend in haste, Captain, before I regret my favor to you.
Captain, think carefully about what you mean to do here.
What are you grousing about, Ade? It's Ben Hornigold come to kill us out there.
Aye, and the traitor needs to die. But what then? Can you say with certainty that you deserve the observatory more than he and his Templars?
No, I can't, and I don't care to try. But if you've a better idea, by all means, tell me.
Forget working with Roberts. Tell the assassins. Bring them here, and let them protect this place.
Aye, I'll bring them here. If they're willing to pay me a good sum for it.
Trim the yards off the wind!
We'll have a hard fight if Hornigold draws us any deeper into this fog. We're nearing the Devil's Backbone.
You mean them crags that look like the backbone of a beast?
Aye. El Espinazo del Diablo, Spaniards call it.
Fall down and screw up!
Furl those men!
There's Hornigold. Getting close.
Stand still's in! Stop!
All ship incoming, Captain! Stone up on the rigging! Matters are in!
Ready to fit, sir! We'll be dashed on the rocks, sir!
Fire! Fire! The captain won't waste up!
We'll be coming back.
Over there, mate!
this day. By God, I'm flaying every last bit of you. Steady up. Keep your backs together, lads. This fight ain't over. I know this bastard, and I... Oh! You could have been a man who stood for something. But you've a killer's heart now, with nothing but metal to show for all your blunders.
Damsite better than you, Ben. The heart of a traitor who thinks himself better than his mates.
Aye, and proven true. What have you done since Nassau fell? Oh, nothing but murder and mayhem.
You threw in with the very kind we once hated!
No! These Templars are different. I wish you could see that. But if you continue on your present course, you'll find you're the only one walking it. With the gallows at its end.
It may be. But now the world has one less snake in it. And that's enough for me.
My services. Business well concluded.
And he will.
Is that pirate hunter dead?
Aye, by my own hand. Why is it you alone can find what so many want?
I was born with memories of this place. Memories of another time entirely, I think. Like another life I've already led.
Curse you for a lurch, man, and speak some sense.
Not today. After you, Captain. The path ahead is dangerous.
Native to this land will put up a fight, Edward. Are you willing to push back if necessary, huh? To kill if needed.
You'll hear from me soon.
Ugh!
Close.
Let's go.
Is this the observatory? All this?
Roberts, have you gone mad?
Quite the contrary, Edward. These wags would have gone mad at seeing what lies beyond this gate. But you... I suspect you're made of sterner stuff. Now, pick up that chest and carry it hither. Dirty and decrepit. Not quite as I remember, but it has been over 80 millennia.
Ah, rot. That's impossible.
Step as if on thin ice, Captain. I must say I'm quite taken by this new vocation of mine, and it may amuse you to know that I have authored my own articles of conduct.
A creed of your own, eh?
To keep the peace, yes. I forbid all gambling upon the deck, for instance, for it leads to more conflict than camaraderie. Desertion during battle is forbidden. And I require that all men keep their pieces and cutlasses clean and fit for service at all times.
Sensible.
And punishable by death if disobeyed.
Look at this place.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Aye. Like something out of a fairy tale. One of them old poems.
There were many stories about this place once. Tales that turned into rumors and again into legend. The inevitable process of facts becoming fictions before fading away entirely.
More blood vials.
Yes. These cubes contain the blood of an old and ancient people. A wonderful race in their time.
The more you talk, man, the less I understand.
I don't expect you to. Only remember this. The blood in those vials is not worth a single real to anyone anymore. It may be again one day, but not in this evil. Here we are.
What's that noise?
Ah, yes. A security measure. Just a moment. There we are.
So what is this place?
Think of it as a large spyglass, such as we sailors carry. A device. Capable of seeing great distances.
This is bloody witchcraft.
No. This is Mr. Jack Rack. Somewhere in the world at this moment.
NASA. This is happening right now. We're seeing through his eyes.
I don't know, Jim. I haven't the faintest idea how to pilot a ship. That ain't work a woman does.
Tosh. I've seen a score of ladies who can reef a sail and spin a capstan.
And would you teach me to fight? With a cutlass, like? And maybe handle a pistol?
All that and more. But you have to want it and work for it. There's no stumbling into true success.
Oi! Lad! That's my lasso making love to. You lay off, or I'll catch ya.
Up your ass, Rackham. Lad's the last thing you should be calling me.
Oh! Oh! Oh, is that right, is it? Lad?
A curious bunch. Let's try another. Governor Woods Rogers.
You have a bold idea, but I must think it carefully through.
A simple pledge of loyalty is all you need suggest to the House of Commons. An oath, a gesture, and a simple ceremonial drum of blood taken from the finger. That's all.
The ministers may give me trouble, but it should be easy enough to convince the House of Lords. They do adore an excess of pomp and circumstance.
Exactly. Tell them it's a show of fealty to the king against those revolting Jacobites.
Yes, indeed.
Oh, these Templars.
The crucial detail is the blood. You must get a sample from each man. We want to be ready when we find the observatory.
Agreed.
A precious tool, you see. Sorcery, that's what it is.
Not so! Every mechanism that gives this device its light is a true and physical thing. Ancient, yes, but nothing supernatural or strange.
We'll be masters of the ocean with that.
Oh, such ambition. There is nothing in my code about loyalty, boy. You played your role. But our partnership is done!
You're a dead man, Roberts! Roberts!
Oh, your jackdaw's flown, Edward. Eh? That's the beauty of a democracy. The many outvote the one. Oh, you could sail with me, but
With a temper as hot as yours, I fear you'd burn us all to cinders. Luckily, I know the king's bounty on your head is a large one, and I intend to collect.
Have you
ever seen the inside of a Jamaican prison, boy? Have you?
That'll pass. It's the Midazolam. I'm sorry about this, but we've had so many security breaches, we were forced to take drastic action. And Olivier is missing. He left for Chicago 2 days ago, but no one's seen him since. I know this seems excessive, but with our high-level security clearance, we have an obligation to our shareholders. Rest assured, we will compensate you when the hacker is found. So get some rest, okay? And if you're up to it, maybe capture some more footage? You're doing amazing work. I can't wait to show you the work we've been doing with your stuff. Take care.
So, they tossed you in the bunker. Nice. Those Templars upstairs aren't taking any chances. I think we need to erase all the dirt they might have on you. Did you hear that? I think I just gave you level 3 security clearance. Now, head to the security room and use the cameras to watch the door to the server farm. Unfortunately, Melanie's in there now. So when I escort her out, that's when you make your move. I'd wipe these servers myself, but as the head of IT, I'd be a suspect. It has to be someone they've already locked up. Ah, these Templars. They run our lives, you know. They decide elections, they control various capital markets, and they inject us with little microchips to track our movements and read our thoughts. It's all very scary. I'm entering the server room now. When you see us leave, get in there.
Yourself, Miss LeMay. My team will handle the investigation.
But you need an extra set of eyes on this thing, John. We don't even know when the hacker's broken. It could take weeks to go through this data.
One, at most.
Still too long. I can't keep my team locked up for a week.
Legally, you can. It's what they signed up for, even if they didn't read their contracts.
Yes, of course. I just hate the idea. So what's the next step?
My team is processing the data now. We'll start sifting through it tonight. Scout's honor. Coffee's on me, okay?
Thank you.
I ditched her at the coffee stand. Find a server containing a network log. Since I have a record of each and every one of your hacks, we'll just search for the timestamps on those and turn that data into something harmless. Easy as that. Here we are. Beautiful. I'll update your communicator one more time. A little program I cooked up just for this purpose. There we go. I think that worked. Try it out.
The dawn of the deadly 18th century. Rogues and sailors band together to live their lives by the sword. With no laws or morals, no gods, and no fear. Only betrayal, mutiny, cruelty, and debauchery. There is plunder to be found on golden beaches. Will you risk life and soul to fight the pirates of nightmares? Benjamin Hornigold, Calico Jack, Charles Vane, and Blackbeard?
Cipher. Feel, but hardly touch. Signal is still too weak, and I am spread thin. Unfocused, like static in fog. Lingering in networks and nodes, the nervous system of the world.
Can you hear?
Perhaps the temple was opened too soon, but this was not by choice. The cataclysm pushed all doubt aside. We bless poor Desmond, who gave his life so that you, the children of our labors, would live on. To fulfill your purpose in ours, in mine. But now is not the time. My strength is not sufficient to inhabit an organic vessel. There is more work to do, more samples to acquire, more artifacts to find before my will can obtain.
What's happening? Tell me!
Make me whole again, my children, my instruments. Bring me forth to fulfill your purpose.
Tell me! No, no, no! Something's wrong! God damn it! She should be here! Now! Living in that goddamned head of yours! Fuck, 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 fuck! Why did she spare you? Why are you still here?
Charges, sir, I'll hear them again.
My lord, His Majesty's court contends that the defendants, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, did piratically, feloniously, and in an hostile manner attack, engage, and take 7 certain fishing boats. Secondly, this court contends that the defendants lurked upon the high seas and did set upon, shoot at, and take 2 certain merchant sloops, thus putting the captains and their crews in corporeal fear of their lives.
Edward James Kenway, born of motley parentage in Swansea, to an English father and Welsh mother, married at 18 to Miss Caroline Scott, now estranged.
She's a beautiful woman, I am told, but not at all well these days.
If you touch her, you bastards, I'll...
Quite a surprise finding you here rotting in a Jamaican prison. We heard rumors that you had taken up with the pirate Roberts.
If you know the observatory's location, tell us now, and you'll be out of here in a flash.
Rogers can hold these British hounds at bay for a time, but this will be your fate if you fail to cooperate.
You, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, are to go from hence to the place from whence you came, and from thence to the place of execution, where you shall be severally hanged by the neck, till you are severally dead, dead, dead!
Oh, Ross!
May God in His infinite mercy be merciful to each of your souls!
We're pregnant! Do you all hear that?
What the devil did she say?
They plead their bellies, my lord.
Aye, you can't hang a woman quick with child, can ye?
Quiet! Quiet! If what you claim is true, then your executions will be stayed, but only until your terms are up.
Then I'll be up the duff the next time you come knocking.
Remove them!
What's your name? Billup, Kenmore, Conway.
It's Walpole, ain't it?
Walpole? Where'd you get that?
Well, that's the rumour going round. As dirty and daft a pirate as ever sailed these West Indies.
Well, whatever his name, gotta make sure he suffers without dying. Orders from the governor. And back to the prisons at sundown.
And massage his feet if he's aching.
Quiet!
Open this gibbet. Oi!
Quiet,
water.
You!
Water.
Oi! You stop that!
This is a warning.
Hey!
Stop. Good morning, Captain Kenway. I have a gift for you. Do not mistake my purpose here. I have come for Anne and Mary, and you owe me nothing for this. But if you would lend me your aid, I can promise you safe passage from this place.
I'll need weapons.
You are comfortable with this, I am told. We must hurry.
worth that easily.
You there! Stop it! Stop, I want to talk to you. Hold mine. Stop there. Stop it! Hold my... Hold that! Oh, God.
You weren't much of a friend, Jack Rackham, nor an able sailor, neither. But you were strange and lively. And you made me laugh more than once. And that's enough to make me sorry for seeing you like this. I hope you found a lasting peace, down there among the dead.
You!
Stop the bastard! Help!
So where were you stationed prior to this assignment?
Virginia, mostly.
Get back here! Not a damn thing. Best get back to
me. See much action?
Thank you.
caught here. Didn't hear what happened after them. Best of luck to you, mate. I wish we'd parted as friends. Me, Edward.
Edward? Who's this fella?
It's all right, Anne. He's a friend. What's wrong with Mary?
She's ill.
And her child?
They took her. No idea where.
I know it pains, my lady, but we must be silent. Can you walk? Lean on me, Mary. Come on.
Search every cell!
Come on, that's it.
You're all right.
Stop. Stop, please.
I ain't leaving you, damn it. Lift your arm.
It's no good.
There's no one here!
I am leaving you no one. Anyway.
Put me down, Edward. Don't die on my account. Go.
This is such a pain in the ass. Damn it. You should have been the one to outlast me.
I've done my part. Will you?
If you came with me, I could. Mary.
I'll be with you, Kim.
What happened to Mary? What's wrong?
Is she gone?
Oh, no. Oh, God! Oh!
What will you do now? Nothing sensible.
You haven't earned this, but they suit you. Good fortune to you, Edward Kenway.
Bring a bottle.
I see some color first.
Will this do? In all your years out here, you could never achieve what I've done in 1/5 the time. Because you're a good man, Edward, see? Goodness
is your disease.
That's my prize, Roberts. Now give it here!
Remember my creed, boy. A short life and a merry one, that is all. The world owes us nothing more than this. So take what you will, and then die before you live to see yourself made a fool.
Give it here.
That's right, boy, take it. I'll sweeten you, maggot. I'll cut you down!
Calm, little puppy, and slink back to your kennel. You haven't the mettle for my brand of madness.
Robert! Welcome aboard, Kenway. It's prizes, plunder, and adventure ahead. Are you game? Out of my way, Ben.
Raise a glass to freedom, lads. Here's to gentlemen of fortune and women of leisure.
To a world full of rogues better than all the kings and queens that kick us about.
As gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. What man with a sensible mind would choose the former life? For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and, withdrawing them, find 'tis better to be a commander than a common man!
Wondering, do I not make you happy?
I'm so close, Caroline. Please,
please! Just let me do this!
It's everything you do, I'll spy, Edward!
It's not spite that's driving me, Mary! It's courage!
Courage for what, man? There's no one left in your life to care!
Goddamn war! I can handle this!
That! Always tearing down when you could be building things up, or building yourself up if nothing else!
Just leave me be!
Change course, Edward! Change your bloody course before it's too late!
Captain Kenway! You look like a bowl of plum duff.
Christ! Oh, I've got a head for 10.
On your feet.
You put me on the spot, Addy. After leaving me with Robert, I should have hard feelings about seeing you here. But mostly I'm bloody glad.
Me too, brother. And you'll be chuffed to know your jackdaw is still in one piece.
So we set sail. You're leaving?
Aye, Edward. But I have another calling elsewhere.
Addy, listen.
When your heart and your head are ready, visit the assassins. I think you'll understand then.
How might I address your needs, sir? Regret. Good day.
Limited use on the road. Northeaster.
Thank you.
Jesus, Ade, what the hell happened here?
You happened here, Edward. The damage you caused 6 years ago has not been undone.
I'm not an easy man to call a friend, am I? Is that why you're here?
To fight beside a man so driven by personal gain and glory is a hard thing, Edward. And I have come to feel the assassins and their creed a more honorable cause. Have I been unfair?
No. For years I've been rushing around taking whatever I fancied, not giving a tinker's curse for those I hurt. And yet here I am, with riches and a reputation, feeling no wiser than when I left home. Yet when I turn around, look at the course I've run. There's not a man or woman that I love left standing beside me.
There is time to make amends, Captain.
Mary. Before she died, she asked me to do good by her. To sort out the mess I made. Can you help me?
Mary was fond of you, Edward. She saw something in your bearing that gave her hope you might one day fight with us.
Aye. She told me.
And what do you think of our creed?
It's hard to say. For if nothing is true, then why believe anything? And if everything is permitted, why not chase every desire?
Why indeed?
It might be that this idea is only the beginning of wisdom, not its final form.
That's quite a step up from the Edor I met here many years ago. So what do you think?
It'll take some getting used to.
The second attack this month, I should have moved this village long ago.
I brought all this upon you years ago, but I will stand by you now.
It will take more than a few favors to call yourself a true assassin, Edward.
One thing at a time, mate.
Only the cut ones.
stay close, Edward. Follow my lead.
Thank you.
Jan Muk Awol Yetel Abishan. And once more, you have our thanks, Edward. You are welcome here.
Thank you, sir. I'll rest here for a time before setting out, if I may. How's her child?
She is a strong woman, but not invincible.
Edward.
I'm sorry for your loss.
If I'd stayed in prison, they'd have taken him from me. He'd never be alive. Maybe this is God's way of saying I'm not fit to be a mother yet. Carrying on like I do. Cursing and drinking and fighting.
You are a fighter, aye. In prison, I heard stories of the infamous Anne Bonny and Mary Read taking on the King's Navy together. Just the pair of you.
It's all true. Anne would have won that day if Jack and his lads weren't passed out in the hold from drink. Everyone's gone, right there. Mary, Rackham, Touch, all the rest. I miss them so, rough as they were. Do you feel that too? All empty inside?
I do. Devil curse me. I know my targets by sight well enough. How will I find them?
We have spies and informants in every city. Visit our bureaus and the assassins there will guide you.
That fixes Torres and Rogers. But Bartholomew Roberts won't be near any city. Might take months to find him.
Or years. But you're a man of talent and quality, Captain Kenway. I believe you will find him.
And if you're at a loss, don't be afraid to call on your quartermaster for aid.
Quartermaster! What's our present course?
Due west, Captain, if it's still Kingston we're sailing for.
It is indeed, Miss Bonny. Call it out.
Weigh anchor and let fall the courses, lads! We're sailing for Jamaica!
How does it feel to bark so loud?
you require my services? My thanks.
Ahoy!
I can keep the heat up. For a pick.
Captain Kenway.
You have something for me?
The present whereabouts of the Templar Woods Rogers. He is attending a small political function, so do it clean.
The word is King George is calling Rogers back to London.
Aye, not happy with his progress in Nassau.
Still too many pirates roaming about from what I hear.
You'll need a disguise to fool the powderheads at this party. I suggest the visiting diplomat, Ruggero Ferraro. He's been on our list for some time.
Understood. Will you send this to England for me?
Aye. The ship leaves tomorrow.
Caroline Scott Kenway, Hawkins Lane, Bristol.
Ah, praise God for imported wines.
Salve. Forgive the lateness of my arrival. I am Ruggiero Ferraro.
Hi, Mr. Ferraro. No problem.
Ladies and gentlemen, a toast to my brief tenure as governor of the Bahamas. For under my watch, no less than 300 avowed pirates and swore fealty to the crown. And yet, for all my successes, His Majesty has seen fit to sack me and call me home to England.
Brilliant! God bless the fucker!
Therefore, hooray! Hooray for the ignoble and ignorant prigs who rule the world with sticks up their asses! Hooray!
And how is Mrs. Rogers these days?
I haven't the faintest idea, and I don't intend to inquire any further. We separated almost 5 years ago, and both our lives have been the better for it.
Forgive my curiosity, Governor.
Perhaps I'll be more candid later, when the remainder of my reason has left.
Privateer once. How is it you lack so much respect for sailors only trying to make their way in this world?
You couldn't possibly understand my motives, cretin! You have spent a whole lifetime dismantling everything that makes our civilization shine.
But I do understand. I've seen the observatory, and I know its power. You'd use that device to spy and blackmail and sabotage.
Yes. And yet all for a greater purpose. To ensure justice. To snuff out lies and to seek truth.
There's no man on earth who needs that power.
Yet you suffer the outlaw Roberts to use it.
No. I'm taking it back. And if you tell me where he is, I'll stop the man.
Here, at the edge of a blade, I find a friend in you at last.
Principe, you mad bastard. Our best sources say Principe.
Is it a revolt? What's happened?
It's done.
Where now?
Grab your kit and pack well. We're sailing for Africa.
What is this good boat's name?
Sailboat Malarkey.
Well, now, me boys, we are bound out to sea.
Sailboat Malarkey.
Oh, windward Caroline, come down to me.
Sailboat Malarkey.
She's lovely aloft and she's lovely below.
Sailboat Malarkey.
But she's best on her back, as you very well know.
Sailboat Malarkey.
Away in St. George's town.
The sailboat Malarkey.
The rats combating the houses down.
The sailboat Malarkey.
I give the word, boys, and all that I know.
The sailboat Malarkey.
To turn and to row with me, Lucy, oh.
The sailboat Malarkey.
Pick her up, boys, and lay her down.
Sailboat Malarkey.
Captain, here's one still kicking.
Who did this?
It were a large vessel, the Royal Fortune.
Roberts.
Offered no quarter. Didn't say nothing.
Thank you.
Why? Who's chasing me now, eh? Is it a spectre come to spook me? You're the gaunt remains of a man I sent to hell.
Our ship was taken in the Philippines. Yeah, I hear you.
But dead, many.
Let's move! Fire! Yeah! Keep the world! Yeah!
him that needs taking. I'll have to order myself.
Man the guns! There's more fodder for you coming! How can I not be impressed by the attention you've paid me? May the best of we two sing praises of the second!
Well, I know myself. And what of you, Edward? Have you found the peace you seek?
I'm not aiming so high as that. For what's peace but a confusion between two wars?
Oh, you're a stoic, then. But perhaps I was wrong about you. She might have had some use for you after all.
She? Of whom do you speak?
Oh, she who lies in wait. Entombed. I had hoped to find her, to see her again, to open the door of the temple and hear her speak my name once more.
Talk sense, man.
Oh, I was born too soon, like so many others before.
Where's the device, Robert?
Destroy this body, Edward. The Templars. If they take me...
Something I can assist with? Most satisfactory.
Kenway.
Alfeia.
I'm assuming this is the friendliest face you've seen since drop an anchor?
Is Havana under curfew on my account?
Aye. Torres seems to think someone's coming after him.
He's not wrong.
A monkey-looking thing? Is that what I think it is?
Aye. Watch. Through the blood of the governor, we can see through his eyes.
That's by the church.
Keep this safe. Just in case.
I'll be at the bureau. Good luck.
Thank you.
Tenemos un asunto pendiente con el tiburón en el castillo. El señor Torres querrá hablar con nosotros personalmente. Esto no es una reunión de sociedad. Seguidnos.
Señor, disculpe, pero ¿por qué tenemos que entrar ahí? Ya han enviado la mayoría de la flota.
¿Estás cuestionando una orden directa, soldado?
No, señor, pero es que...
Bien. ¡Atención!
You're done, Torres. Christ! This again, eh? You're too skilled for swordplay. Oh. gunplay. You're a canny one, Jones.
Cortate el paso!
No man's immune to a pistol shot, I reckon. I can't score a hit like this. Are you weak against bullets?
Enemigo a tiro, señor.
Tengo línea de tiro.
Podría darle entre las cejas.
You could speak, mate. It would gladden me to hear your side. You humbled me once, and I took that hard lesson, and I bettered myself. Die, knowing that for all of our conflict, you helped make a soldier out of a scoundrel. Leave this life for a lasting peace, down among the dead.
Thank you.
We got word Torres left the city. Who were you chasing?
That vial was labeled Torres, but held the blood of his second. Where's he gone?
Left port this morning, heading west along the coast.
The observatory.
Will we follow?
Send word to Atabai. We've cornered our man.
Thanks. It is much to my mind.
Hold the treasure yourself.
Torres doesn't know I have it.
So why bring it to him and risk its capture?
I'd like him to know I have it just before he dies. That's Torres and his men.
And you're going to do what exactly?
Find our way past them.
Ship coming after us, sir! That's a man of war!
Ready to fuck
it! All top! Control mates, let's move! Ghost to ghost! Fire!
Thank you.
this Taurus? And what's your man done to earn a death sentence?
He's a Templar, like Rogers and Hornigold. Men cooking up schemes to use the observatory for ill purposes. For power and control. The violence he'd cause with this thing would be subtle but heavy. Deadly, yet leaving no mark. Does that make sense?
Like, if there was a drought and people was thirsty, and one man had a large cask of water but gave a sip to none, he'd be a killer with no blood in his hands.
Aye, like that.
Clear enough.
No, they're here. Deep in the jungle.
Soldiers, just there. What should we do? Jesus, look at all this. Corpses for miles.
They brought every ounce of men they had.
strange. What is this?
Later, lad. I'll tell you all when this is finished.
We've come to see.
Aye. Stand watch here, and let none follow.
Fit till there doesn't fight, die.
Infierna! Infierna!
Venga, muévete!
No puedo! Mis piernas no responden!
Déjalo! Déjalo!
¡Has oído! ¡Levántate! ¡No quiero dejarte aquí!
¡Será vuestro funeral!
¡Por favor! ¡Por favor! ¡No me hagas! ¡Está aquí!
Captain Kenway, ever a splinter in my side. Does this murder fulfill you?
I'm only seeing a job done, Torres. As you'd have done with me.
As we have done, I think. You have no family anymore, no friends, no future. Your losses are far greater than ours.
That may be. But killing you rights a far greater wrong than ever I did.
You honestly believe that?
You would see all of mankind corralled into a neatly furnished prison, safe and sober, yet dulled beyond reason and sapped of all spirit. So I, with everything I've seen and learned in these last years, I do believe it.
You wear your convictions well. They suit you.
Torres awakened something fierce. Are we safe?
With the device returned, I believe so.
What do you call this place?
Captain Kenway's Folly!
It's a wall to sue to kill. Ka-wenen. We will seal this place and discard the key. Until another sage appears, this door will remain locked.
There were vials when I came here last. Filled with the blood of ancient men, Robert said, but they're gone now.
Then it's up to us to recover them, before the Templars catch wind of this. You could join us in that cause.
I will, but only after I fix what I mangled back home.
It arrived last week.
There isn't much time. The short of it is, you saw my beloved Juno. And for a brief moment, I thought she might occupy this tender body of yours. But something went wrong. And now, she's back out there, adrift. Oh, she was magnificent once. One of a race of beautiful, wonderful creatures. They created your kind. Did you know that? Your people were tools to them. That's all you have ever been. That's all you should ever be. One day soon, I hope. For the world is nearly ready for her return. Wired. Prepared for a second coming. Uh-oh. Here they come. Those Templars. Or maybe assassins this time. Idiots. All of them. I envy you. It was her wish that I be here to greet her. It was her experiment that made it possible for my rebirth as one of these things.
Stay down!
Get down on your back! Now!
He's got a gun!
Guide me into the grave, beloved! I am your instrument!
Put the gun down! Drop it!
Drop your weapon!
Clear! Clear! Check his vitals!
He's bleeding fast!
Check the victim!
Are you okay? Can you hear me? Hello? Talk to me! You all right?
There you are. Thank God. I hope you feel well. You look good. Can you stand? Good. Try walking around. A doctor came by, said there wasn't anything.
that the liquid in the syringe was far, far below a lethal dose. I feel terrible about all this. About everything. All our evidence pointed to you, but it was John all along. God, the things we found on his computer. Whatever you need, we'll provide. You've done an amazing job. Speaking of which, our trailer is finished. Would you like to see it? I owe you that much. There we go. I uploaded it to your database. You can watch it here or at your Animus. I think you'll love it. It really captures the essence of the era. So, take care. And again, thank you.
In a world where pirates rule the waves, these men will discover that nothing is sacred and everyone is committed to rum, plunder, and women.
Hola, ladies.
This summer, Abstergo Entertainment invites you aboard for the adventure of a lifetime. So sharpen your cutlasses, shine your hooks, and sail with the Devils of the Caribbean. This virtual experience is not being rated.
Was such a, how to put it? Fanatic. Fanatic is the best word, I suppose.
We take who we can get.
Exactly, exactly. Well put. We saw in John an opportunity to burrow deeper into Abstergo's cloud servers, and I'm not ashamed to say we took it. Not realizing, of course, that he was enlisting you to help him. And to blame, should anything go wrong. I suppose it all worked out very nicely in the end. Most of it, anyway.
What Sean really wants to say is, if you're up for more hacking, we are too. John gave you level 3 security clearance before he died. You should use it. The assassins don't have the resources to pay you like the Templars do, but we'll make it worth your while.
Look, we should really cut it short, Bex. 20 seconds.
All right. Good luck.
Cheers, mate. And top-notch work, really top-notch. Give yourself a pat on the back. And happy hacking.
Gentlemen, how do you find it here?
It will work for us. But our goal must be to scatter our operations. To live and work among the people we protect, just as Altaïr Ben La'ahad once counseled.
Well, until that time, it's yours as you see fit.
Edward, Captain Woods Rogers survived his wounds. He has since returned to England, shamed and in great debt, but no less a threat.
I will finish that job when I return. You have my word. Evening, Anne.
Edward?
I'll be sailing for London in the next few months. I'd be a hopeful man if you were beside me.
England's the wrong way around the globe for an Irish woman.
Will you stay with the assassins?
No, I haven't got that kind of conviction in my heart. You?
In time, aye. My mind is settled and my blood is cooled.
Sail ho! Coming into the cove!
You're a good man, Edward. And if you learn to keep settled in one place for more than a week, you'll make a fine father, too. better I have. I spent it in good company, and all the harm that e'er I've done, alas, it was to none but me. And all I've done for want of wit, to memory now I can't. So let me the parting glass. Good night and joy.
Jackdaw is a ship, Jenny, not a boat.
But did you always know?
No. No, I learned after leaving Bristol.
After you left Mother?
Well, I didn't leave your... I didn't leave without saying goodbye, that is. It was an arrangement, you see, between your mother and me.
She said you left her. She said you always talked about sailing a boat and making money in the New World.
I did always want to sail a ship, that's true. But not for a lark. To support us. To take care of her. And you.
Not me. Mother said you didn't know about me. She said you wrote only once a year, and that she never knew where to find you.
That's all true, and I'm sorry for that. If I'd known earlier, I might have come home. I hope that I would have.
You were busy, that's what I think.
I was, but that wouldn't have mattered.
Can I steer your boat?
Boat? I see no boat here. Do you?
I mean ship, obviously. I don't see the difference anyway.
Ah, it's a very simple one, Jenny. A ship can carry a boat, but a boat cannot carry a ship.
Why then, everything is a ship, large and small, but for my toy boat, the one I take into the bath with me.
That's a clever way of seeing it. Is it hard to talk about Caroline, Jenny? About your mother?
No. She passed some years ago. I miss her, but it's all right.
Was she in pain?
I don't know. I don't think so. She was very happy for quite some time. Then, not so happy. I didn't see her much after that. Then, she was gone.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry I wasn't there for you.
It's all right. You're here now. And we're on an adventure.
Only a little one, I hope. I can't handle too many more surprises.
Do you think we'll see a whale?
Yes, there's a very good chance.
And what about pirates? Will I see pirates?
No. Not much chance of that, I think.
Oh, that's rather sad. I should have liked to have seen one.
Tell you what, Jenny. As soon as these winds die a little, I'll let you steer the Jackdaw. One little trick at the helm before sundown.
Yay!
Miss Jennifer Kenway, may I introduce myself?
Jennifer Scott, if you please.
I'm sorry,
My daughter was raised by her mother, Caroline, until she passed away some years ago. Jenny prefers to use her surname to mine.
Ah, please forgive my ignorance.
I will. She may not.
Father, help me.
This little rascal, however, is a Kenway. What's wrong, Hayfen?
I can't see the stage.
Up we go. How's that?
Fine. But won't your arms tire?
Hey, I'm not so old as that. But if they do, then we shall quit this posh gig and go and meet your mother for some chocolate at White's. How's that sound?
Yes, please.
Okay, hush now.
Thank you.
Thank you.